Hi everyone, I am so excited to present to you a really cool challenge and a cool series of videos called the Solve It Team. And welcome to the Solve It Team. And the idea of this series is that we believe in you and we need your perspective, your energy, your sense of hope, but also your perspective on what the world needs and what you think are areas that you can help, who you can help, and what you think you can invent to help people. So the goal of this series is to present some strategies, some tips that people all around the world, students, parents, teachers, mentors, would want to share with you of what has worked for them. And the idea is that you find a problem that you care about and that the world needs, and we will build a solution together, and we will show you some common ways of doing it and some things to keep in mind. But we really want to hear your voice. And I think a lot of this will be new. It'll be like a journey. It'll be an adventure. And we really hope that this journey is going to be absolutely amazing for you. It'll open all sorts of doors, all sorts of horizons, but it will also help you understand yourself better. And maybe you'll find some friends online that you can work with to actually create a meaningful invention and bring it to the world. And the world will be better for it. I think we all need a lot of compassion these days, a lot of warmth and love, and the world is filled with this goodness. And I think we need this light, and this is one way. I think technology is an amazing way to spread this light to everyone. Okay, so here we go. Over the next couple of weeks, we will share some videos on how to tackle, how to find problems, how to break it down, what works, what doesn't work, how to deal with the frustration that you may feel, and actually end up with something really cool. And we will create a series of videos with partners from all around the world, helping you create mobile apps, and also helping you create some AI-based, artificial intelligence-based prototypes. So two different types of technical videos that will help you support and figure out what is the best tool that you need to tackle your problem. Okay, so here we go. So this first video will be about identifying a problem. And most people think that this is an obvious immediate step, but actually it turns out it's very, very hard to do. And I've been trying to do this for so many years, and I think I may have one tip for you to start. And so I want to share that with you. But what I do want to also say is these are my interests, my perspectives, and what we want to hear from you is your interests, your perspectives, your view of the world. And no view is wrong. Each person has their own magic lens, and we want to see that and amplify that. Okay, so the very first way I want to show is when you try to find the intersection between your interests, what maybe you need, what your family needs, and because this is your immediate world, and then you can go to what the world needs. So what I want to show is what are my interests, and I have a lot of interests. And I want to show, share that these are my interests, right? So my perspective. And when you do this exercise for yourself, you will want to figure out what are your interests. So I have a lot of hobbies and a lot of things that I like. So I love animals. I love nature. I love exercise. I do a lot of exercise every day. I like to paint. I like to read, and then I like to build model rockets. So what do we do with this massive list? So another step to think about is, well, what do I need? What do I need in my life? And thankfully, I am very lucky. I have my basic needs, but what I feel I have areas for improvement is that I can be more humble. I tend to very quickly think that I know all the answers and I don't listen to people. So I feel that this is an area of improvement for me. So the next thing I want to try to explore is what I think my family needs. And I think that my family, some members of my family could do with a little bit more exercising or even a little bit more reading. So, okay, I'll put that in that circle. And now broadening out, I want to look at what I think the world needs and also that intersects or aligns with my interests, my values. And of course, different people will have different issues that resonate with them. And one way to start would be looking at the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals, the UN SDGs. And so I want to share some that I think align with what I care about, because it's not just enough to find a problem. You still also have to create a solution, and that journey takes time. And so there'll be many times when you feel frustrated and bored, and you're like, "This, I cannot do this. This is too hard." And so that's when you need to dig deep into what motivates you, what you care about, what you think the world needs. And so this alignment is very important to do upfront. So one of the issues that I think I feel very strongly about is the climate action SDG, which aligns with the SDG number 13. Another one is that of supporting seniors, elderly people. I think that a lot of education systems maybe don't think about introducing technology and new ways of learning to this group of people. And I think that this is an area that we can think about, we can help. Another very, very big problem is that of poverty, and especially when it affects children, and trying to do something about that. So that's the UN SDG number one. And lastly, there is a growing need to support people who have been displaced from their countries, from their homes, due to different types of war or natural disasters. I want to help refugees. So that's aligned with the UN SDG number 16. So this is the whole set of circles that I tried to frame a starting point. And so how can we go forward? So going back to whether I want to try to tackle the humility problem that I have, I am not sure a mobile app is something that is what I need. It could just be sort of mindfulness and training or reading more books every day sort of practicing some thought processes. So I don't know whether an app would help me that much. So I will put that aside. Looking at my interests and matching with what the world needs, the thing that immediately sticks to me is the climate action one. And maybe there's a way where it can be connected to my interest in animals and my desire to help them. I think a lot of farm animals are a part of the meat consumption industry, there's something that can be done to help that. They're also directly linked to greenhouse gas, carbon dioxide emission. So one app could be, and I want to come at it from a positive point of view. There are many initiatives that make people feel guilty for eating meat, and I don't think that's the right way to do that, because there are many reasons for which you may have a certain type of diet. So one way to do that is to think about the positive when you take a particular action. And so this applies to other apps as well. So instead of saying making you feel guilty, every time you make a conscious decision to eat plant-based food, maybe there's a reminder in the mobile app that celebrates you and says, this is the animal that you've saved. And so we all are compassionate people and we want to feel good. So I think what's really good about a mobile app is that it can give you the feedback at the right time, as opposed to a website or a book or any other type of engagement. So that could be one area to explore further. I think another app that could be helpful to a lot of people could be the one that motivates for exercise. I think I'm going to start with maybe trying to motivate one person in my family. And then if it's effective, then we can share that for more people. So I'm thinking of my mom. She is in India. It's very hot. It's hard to exercise outside. And so and she gets bored. And so I'm wondering if I could create an app that sends her daily motivation and inspiration. I think there are lots of fitness apps right now And it's not that we don't know what to do. It's more that we lack the motivation. It's so much easier to sit and watch a video or to just sit on your couch and feel comfortable rather than to go out and sweat and do hard things, especially when you're tired. So I think there could be an app that reminds you how you feel when you exercise, you feel calmer, you feel happier. And I think the app can be positive rather than a lot of the current fitness apps that make you compete with others, and there's leaderboards and lots of workouts that don't really, that they're randomly suggesting more things for you to do. So I think there's room for improvement there. I am curious about creating an app that can help elderly people, senior citizens learn new technology. I think it could be similar to maybe the exercise one where it's sending daily inspiration, but I don't know whether this is number one on my list. It's probably number three. So to try to figure out which app do I go forward with, I want to think about another thing, and which is persistence. This journey is going to be a long journey, probably going to take me 12 weeks, 13 weeks, 3-4 months. And I won't be able to do it alone. I'll need some friends. So I need to think about what are my support systems that I can lean on that will motivate me, provide me with the right expertise and the right guidance. And so I want to share this journey. There's going to be, in the beginning, there's going to be a lot of learning that I'll have to do. I don't know how to code an app. I need to learn that. And then when I finish learning some of the basic tutorials, then there'll be the really hard challenge of, well, how do I take these tutorials and break it down into applying it to my app? And so I may be intimidated and feel demotivated. And so that's when my interest goes down. And there's where I can build a team. I can find other people who may be interested in the same problem. I can reach out to experts. And here I feel like I have more people who know about exercise than, say, about climate action. And then my interest will rise again. And as I start to build something, I can quickly test it out with people. In my case, I can test it out with my family members and get feedback, and that'll keep motivating me to keep going. And so I think my interest and my learning will slowly rise. And by that time, it will be ready to the time maybe to launch a first prototype or first version. And I think that's a super exciting part of it and will definitely motivate me. And I think overall, the biggest thing that I'll probably walk away learning is a lot about myself. Like, what frustrates me? When am I motivated? How do I handle myself over a long project? But then also, I think if hopefully I would have created something that helps others. And even if I help one person do what they wanted to do and make the world a little bit better, I'll feel really, really happy. So I hope that you will join us and be part of the Solve It team, because we really need you. And I hope that you will come with us on this journey.